So the next question is from Vishwa. She asked, how do you handle constructive criticism?
Okay, how do you handle constructive criticism? Be thankful. What else? If someone tells me, I'll narrate one incident quickly. I'll not take more than 3-4 minutes. In early, I mean, especially for those people who should work on the throughput management that should go. I was just fresh engineer and I started working with machine tool division of Tata Motors. And initial itself, I was given a very complex assignment. Ramji was my boss, MTech gold medalist metallurgy. And he said, I think you'll be able to do it. That's the reason I have given you this particular assignment. I said, fine, if you have the trust, I will not lay you down. I did it. And on the day, Wednesday, I went to him. That time Thursday was off. And I told Ramji, I worked for 2 shifts consecutive. And here I am with the drawings ready. It was a big helicopter gearbox. They wanted me to show the cut sections and all. But I told Ramji, look, this is what I have did. He smiled nicely and he said, come Dharanja, we'll have a cup of coffee, cup of tea. And then we went. And I was expecting Ramji will say, wow, good, hard work, da da da. He didn't speak a word, he just smiled and he took me to the cup of tea, glass made coffee, tea, and had a sip. And he said, Dharanja, I think you are inefficient in planning or disobedient in executing. What do you think? Now tell me, will you call this as destructive feedback, constructive feedback, constructive criticism?
It's feedback.
It's feedback. So he said, Dhananjay, I think you are inefficient in planning or disobedient in executing. Now, that's what your question is. How to handle constructive criticism? I took a pause. Fortunately, I'm groomed in this culture. People who respect a lot, time, overall. So I asked Ramji, can you elaborate, please? Because honestly, I was hoping that you will admire me, you will appreciate me. Ramji said, I am definitely appreciating you, no doubt about it. I checked all your drawings and I couldn't find a single mistake there. And I had full confidence on you. So you did solid job. But you told me that you had to work for 2 consecutive shifts. And that's the reason I'm saying, have you planned for those 2 consecutive shifts? I said, no. But then why did you work for 2 consecutive shifts? You have seen me. I never work late. I never, stay long for 2 consecutive shifts. Why did you do that? I said, okay, then what stopped you from telling me on Tuesday that I will deliver it on Friday? No, but I had promised you, na. Don't do it again. Now, don't tell me. Don't you feel that this was a solid contribution to me in my early career? Right. First of all, he told me that, hey, working late is not the point of appreciation. At least I don't appreciate that. Secondly, if you feel that there is a delay, come and communicate with me rather than jumping and bumping there. Why didn't you communicate? I would have helped you. So this is constructive criticism. This is an example. And what else I can do now? In fact, that time itself, I said, boss, thank you so much. A solid gift, full career. Today, there are few people because of whom I am here in project management. 92, I got this particular criticism. What else? Thankful.
Yeah. So we have a last question from Urvi. She asked, how do we deal with feedback which is drastically negative, but unfortunately true and in turn breaks our morale? And how should we use it to our advantage?
Super. First of all, highest appreciation for sequence of the adverbs and verbs that you use. Varad, can you restate the question?
Yes, sir. Just a minute. How do we deal with feedback which is drastically negative but unfortunately true and in turn breaks our morale? How should we use it to our advantage?
Right. So, First of all, the very fact that you have accepted that that is true, good one. So, drastically negative. Now, drastically negative has come up from the ego. Now, last point from my side or for this particular question. The way I told you that when you give the constructive feedback, intent, area, and action. So, when you receive the feedback, I need to pay attention to iska intent kya, what is the intent that is telling me? Otherwise, I would have lost a solid advice that Ramji gave me. It's not his loss, it's my loss, boss. He told me, what do you mean by inefficient in executing and disobedient, whatever. So, I need to pay attention to intent. Drastically negative. Is language used is offensive or intention is to offend you? No, language use is very, very ruthless probably, right? But what, unfortunately true, that means he's speaking truth. He has the courage to tell you. Perfect. So once again, what is the area of importance that you'll pay attention to? The person, the language, or the intent and the action? Right? Varad, read this question again and then we'll go. So drastically negative, but true, and finally,
yes, sir. How do we deal with feedback which is drastically negative but unfortunately true and in turn breaks our morale? How should we use it to our advantage?
Correct. So, the question is basically how to avoid getting into that, you know, luxury of self-pity, that morale has gone down. It's a luxury. Pay attention to the intent and say that this person is giving that, he's speaking the truth. Go back. Make the question, make the feedback quantitative. Either this person will give the quantitative feedback or you will make the. Now, that's the reason I have given you. You will constantly pay attention to design, development, delivery. Bas. Is it okay? Sir, any doubts, any questions?